Hey there! Welcome to this video on symmetry. Let's get started. What happens when I take these two shapes and split them in half? The shapes are identical in size and shape, right? I can see this more clearly by folding the images on top of each other. So we can see that when I've drawn a line, I have created two congruent shapes. Congruent means that the two shapes are identical. When you're able to draw a straight line through the center of a shape, and it creates two congruent shapes, then these two shapes are also symmetrical. Symmetry comes from the Greek word symmetria, meaning a similar agreement of parts. Symmetry, just like congruent shapes, means that one shape becomes exactly like the other when you move it in some way. The movement could be a turn, a flip, or a slide. When a shape is not symmetrical, then this is referred to as asymmetrical. Some shapes have lines of symmetry. A line of symmetry is a line that splits the shape in half, creating an identical shape. Some shapes only have one line of symmetry, some have two, and some have several. However, to draw a line of symmetry, we must first identify the point of symmetry. This is because the point of symmetry marks the point that the lines of symmetry could pass through. A point of symmetry is when there is a position or central point on an object or shape where the central point splits the object in two identical parts. And every single line and angle on the other side of the central point is the exact same distance from the central point on each side. That was a lot. Let's take a look at what I mean. Where both identical lines of the cross intersect, we can see that there is a point of symmetry. But let's take a look at the definition to make sure. So let me draw this line here. Point of symmetry. Okay, does the point split the cross into two identical or congruent shapes? Well, if we imagine folding it over across this point, it would then split it in half. So check. Is every single line or angle of the cross the exact same distance from the point on each side? So are all these angles congruent and the same exact distance from this point? Is our question. Based on what we can see, it definitely appears that way. However, to be 100% sure, we would need to measure every single line and angle. But for this exercise, I've used an example where we're assuming that all the lines and angles are the exact same distance. So, check. Now, let's practice finding lines of symmetry. Since we've already found the point of symmetry on the cross, let's see how many lines of symmetry it has. How many times can we split the cross and get identical parts? So we can split it right here. We can split it another time right here, through here, and through here. So it gives us 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there are 4 lines of symmetry here, but after 4, there are no other lines that would give us 2 identical parts. Great job, guys. Let's try another. How many lines of symmetry does the dog have? Or how many lines can you draw that create multiple identical parts? Let's see. If we did it this way, we wouldn't get 2 identical parts because he has a lower half and then a head. So if we do it right here through the center from the top to the bottom, we'll get 2 eyes, kind of 2 parts of the nose, 2 halves of the mouth, 2 halves of the body, and 2 of the legs. So we can assume that there's 1 line of symmetry. If there were any more lines, then we would not have identical parts. What about the side of the dog? Do you see any lines of symmetry? No. Each end of the dog has different shaped parts. The head is different than the tail. Let's move on. Okay, now what about this thought bubble? Is there a line you can draw to create 2 identical parts? No. Let's see how many lines we can draw to split this hexagon into identical parts. 1 here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You guys have done a really great job. Keep practicing and be looking for shapes that are symmetrical in your classroom, in your house, outside, or wherever you are. Symmetry is everywhere, and it's very important. Architects and engineers use symmetry to design sturdy buildings and other objects. Interior designers use symmetry and asymmetrical design to make their work more appealing to look at. People everywhere use symmetry in some way. I hope that this video is helpful, and be sure to check out more of our videos by subscribing below. See you next time.